And the Israeli Prime Minister Ehud Olmert has met with the Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas in the first in a series of fortnightly meetings. Both sides agreed it was a good beginning. They're scheduled to meet next in the Palestinian town of Jericho.
Well, let's get more on that story now. Pleased to say I'm joined by Jerry Lewis from Israel Radio and Sharif Nashashibi, the chairman of Arab Media Watch. Thank you both for joining me. This meeting, was it just not really a photo opportunity?
Well, I think the most important thing to come from the meeting was the fact that Ehud Olmert said that he was willing to take the Arab Peace Initiative as a basis for negotiations. And that's very important because Israel had previously rejected that offer. So hopefully, action will follow words. And I think, we've had a lot of words so far, and hopefully action will follow. There's a meeting in a few days of Arab ministers to discuss the Arab Peace Initiative. So hopefully this will lead to something.
Well, that's basically it, isn't it, Jerry? There was an hour's worth of words today, but nothing really achieved.
Well, not that much achieved, but it's a positive beginning. The question is, both leaders, both Abbas and Olmert, are weak politically in both their own sectors. Abbas can't deliver a security plan yet, even though he set up a security panel. And Olmert has got a crumbling government. He doesn't have a party which is going to give him much support unless there are some positive signs from the peace process. What he's looking for now from Abbas are two principal things. One, the return of Gilad Shalit as quickly as possible. That will bolster Olmert's position. And second of all, proof positive that the security committee being set up with Hania's involvement is going to stop the rockets fired.
But the situation surrounding Gilad Shalit was actually discussed in the very first meeting in June last year, but there's been no breakthrough at all.
Abbas promised to deliver him, and nothing has happened. That's Abbas's weakness.
Well, Israel has rejected the reciprocal list of prisoners to be released, so there needs to be ground given on both sides.
Well, the only grounds Israel have made very clear: we will not release, Israel spokesman, not release any prisoner with blood on their hands.
Well, Sharif,
plenty of others who will be released.
What are the expectations in the region from these meetings?
I mean, there's a lot of skepticism because, we've been here before. There have been meetings before and as you said, there's a lot of words, too little action. I don't think too many people are holding their breath. But having said that, there is more momentum now than there has been for a very long time. So hopefully this might lead to something. But as Jerry said, both leaderships are very weak. I think Ehud Olmert might be counting on the fact that there was a recent poll that more Israelis favor a positive response to the Arab initiative than those against a positive response. So he might be trying to capitalize on that.
What are Israelis hoping to achieve out of these meetings?
Well, once the next process is underway, which is the talks with some reciprocal arrangements, money's already been paid over to the Palestinians, to help the Palestinians get out of the grave economic situation that they're in, the border crossings are going to be opened, but the gun smuggling and the ammunition smuggling across the Egyptian border has to be tackled urgently. Once the rockets stop firing, then Israel will be more constrained to start lifting the controls and the barriers into the Gaza-Israel sector, allowing more people to cross, allowing more people to get an economic benefit from that, get jobs, and then, hopefully, we can talk on serious issues like Jerusalem and the refugees.
But Mr. Olmert said a month ago that he was ready to make big concessions. We've seen no sign of that so far.
There won't be any concessions until the basis of Abbas being able to deliver a peace process are proven. Gilad Shalit is one very positive sign. The stopping of the rockets firing is another. But the other thing which is worrying everybody is the fighting between Hamas and Fatah in Gaza. That lack of stability, the inability of Hamas to say we accept Israel's existence does worry Israelis.
It's effectively deadlock, isn't it?
Well, look, these problems will persist as long as there is an occupation. You simply can't discuss these issues and just prolong them and hope that they will, we can continue this forever if we want to. As long as there is an occupation, we're going to have these problems. If you end the occupation, the rockets won't be fired, there will not be prisoners on each side. All these issues will be resolved. So let's take the ball by the horns.
But Israel's pulled out of Gaza already. What else do they need to do?
The Gaza is still technically occupied under international
because
law because
terrorism.
Israel controls access into and out
Why?
Of the Gaza Strip.
Because of terrorism.
You know that, Jerry.
Sheriff,
I'm sorry.
Do you believe it helps or hinders having the United States involved in all this? Because they effectively have got the two parties together to talk on a bi-weekly basis.
Well, I think the US the US participation is necessary. However, they've consistently failed to be an honest broker in the talks. I think, I mean, once the US is actually going to take a neutral stance on this, then I think that their participation will be much more useful.
And just one final question to both of you, actually. How significant is the next meeting that it would take place in Jericho?
I think we have to wait and see. A lot can happen in the next few weeks, especially in a region like the Middle East. So it's difficult to say now. But I think we should keep eyes on the meeting on Wednesday of the Arab ministers, and let's hope things move forward. Jerry?
I think it's a positive step. And what's interesting as well is Olmert is still saying and trying to stop further settlement expansion. There will be occasional slip-ups on that. But the fact that he's prepared to take that on board, he has got the backing of a majority of Israelis still, and the fact that Netanyahu is barking and biting at his heels politically, everybody knows if Olmert fails and if the Olmert government fails, Netanyahu comes in, there'll be a very different scenario, less positive towards the Palestinians. So everybody has to make the best of what there is at the moment.
Jerry Lewis and Sharif Nashashibi, thank you both.
Pleasure.